Creating the dashboard you see here is simple in the Dashboard Designer for Dashboards 2.0. You'll learn how to set up bar and combination charts, pyramid charts, gauges with traffic lighting, and radar charts. From the home page, select Dashboards. Click Create and select Dashboard 2.0 to open the Dashboard Designer. The designer has a palette on the left where you can select your data source, a canvas in the middle where you arrange your dashboard components, and a properties pane on the right where you can set dashboard, chart, and component-specific properties. You can drag a cube to the canvas for a quick analysis or use a pre-built form. For this dashboard, I'll use Forms. Let's start with a form that shows balance sheet data and display it as a bar chart. Notice that you can click both the quarters and the bars in this chart to drill down to more detail. Drill down isn't something you need to enable in the Dashboard Designer. Rather, it's built into the way the underlying form is set up. Here's the form for this chart. Notice that the quarters in the columns and some of the accounts in the rows are set up to drill down to more detail. If your forms include drill down points like this, then charts based on those forms can drill down too. In the Properties pane, select the Bar tab to customize the chart properties. You can select a scaling option. Auto uses the highest value in the grid as a guide, and None shows raw data values. I'll select Millions. The bars can be displayed vertically or horizontally. You can control the legend placement or hide it. You can also display the data labels inside, centered in, or outside the bars. And you can show or hide grid lines. We'll look at the rest of the properties with our next chart. I'll add a component that shows revenue, costs, and profit percent, and show it as a bar chart. I'll maximize the component so I can see it better. Notice that the values for the percentage are so much lower than the other data, the bars aren't visible in the chart. One way to compensate is to enable a logarithmic scale so the smaller values are plotted. Another option is to enable a dual y-axis for the percentage. Now you can compare the trend for gross profit percent to total revenue and total cost of sales and services, even though the values are vastly different. You can also set custom ranges for the X, Y, and dual Y axes. I'll move the legend to the top and select custom colors for each series. On the Chart Properties tab, you can edit the chart title and set a custom background color. Under Visualization, you can see the data source type and the underlying form name. You can also select a different chart type here. Instead of a bar chart, let's make this a combination chart. For charts with lines, you can set the line weight. By default, the data series are displayed in order as a bar-line-area combination. In this example, total revenue is a bar, total cost of sales and service is a line, and gross profit margin is an area. You can change the combination order to best support the data series. I'll select Bar Area Line. Next, I'll add a component for income statement measures that can be visualized as a pyramid chart. On the Pyramid Properties tab, I'll move the legend to the bottom and make the pyramid 3D. I'll also remove the chart title. We'll reposition and resize the dashboard components for readability at the end. Next, let's add a gauge with traffic lighting for total revenue. A gauge form should only have one data value. Select the gauge chart type. I'll remove the chart title. There are three different gauge types: circular, horizontal, and vertical. You can set the minimum and maximum values for the gauge. The desired goal controls how traffic lighting is displayed. In this example, the goal for revenue is high. For an expense, it would be low. You can create custom threshold labels, which are displayed in the hover pop-up. You can also customize the threshold values. For the last component, let's add a radar chart for 4 quarters of balance sheet data. I'll show the grid lines. There are multiple subtypes of radar chart that work for different datasets. A line type would also work for this dataset, but with an area type, the series would overlap. Scatter and bubble types expect only one group of a series, so in this case, they'd only show Q1 data. I'll hide the legend and go back to the dashboard. Now let's rearrange our components for readability. You can drag and drop components to move them in the dashboard. You can resize components on the Chart Properties tab. Finally, let's set the general dashboard properties. Enter a name for the dashboard. I'll show component borders and hide POV bars. I'll also set a custom background color. Minimize the properties panel to view the full canvas and save the dashboard. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.